Hello all, I'm Viru from electronicsinnovation.com. I'm your host for this episode. In the previous episode, we have set up this LPSAT gateway and registered on the Things Network server. We have also seen that the gateway successfully connected to the Things Network server and transmitted its status message. We have also explored that what are the event details the gateway includes in that status message. In this video, we are going to develop LoRa and Node, which can be activated on ABP mode with RFM95 module and Arduino Uno to publish Hello Electronics Innovation World message. As we have discussed in the earlier video, the data which is being transmitted over the LoRaWAN protocol is encrypted. So we will also see how to decrypt that data and see what is the exact data in that data packet. So let's see how we can do that. The RFM95 module breakout PCBs which are being used in this tutorial are sponsored and manufactured by PCBWare.com. I would like to take a moment and thank PCBWare.com for sponsoring the video. PCBWare.com has been an essential company that supports makers like me around the world building professional PCB projects. They also support some of your favorite YouTubers with their projects. Without PCBWare, some of the best projects posted online every day wouldn't be existing or not available. I am feeling grateful to thank PCBWare in this way for everything they are doing for the maker community. PCBWare.com is an online PCB manufacturing enterprise which provides all services you need to make hardware for your IoT or embedded devices. If you have similar requirement, do check out their website for more details. They have offers also. The link is in the description below. In the previous video, we have registered the LPSAT gateway on the TTN and configured the gateway to connect with the Things Network platform. Now we are going to work on the application section of the TTN platform. Go to the application section and then click on add application. The warner will be selected default. If you want, you can change it from here. Enter the application ID. This can be alphanumeric string, but only lowercase alphabets are allowed. Then enter the application name. This can be anything. Uppercase alphabets are also allowed here. If you want, you can also add a description for the application here. Then click on create application. That's it, a brand new application has been created. In this application, we can add our end devices. If you have a ready-made device from certified manufacturer, you can add that device here. But we are developing our own device, so that can be added in the manual category. Select the LoRaWAN version. We have to specify which version of the LoRaWAN our device is using. Select MAC 1.0.3. Then select the operating frequency. 865 to 867 MHz selected, as I am from India. Here you have to observe one thing if you are from India. The frequency plan 865 to 867 MHz is available on the MAC 1.0.3 or later versions only. You will not find this 865 to 867 MHz frequency band on MAC 1.0.2 or lower versions. So keep in mind that. Click on this. Select activation mode. Either it is OTA, over the air activation, or ABP, activation by personalization. In our case, it is ABP. Leave the rest of the settings default and click on generate DAV UI, device address, app session key and network session key. We have to configure our end node with these credentials. We will see that in coming minutes. Then click on the registered end device. That's it. The device has been created successfully. Let us build the LoRa end node with Arduino Uno and RFM95 module. Here is the circuit diagram to interface RFM95 with Arduino Uno. After connections, the circuit might be something like this. Now it's time to program this LoRa end node. Visit the GitHub page and download the Arduino LMIC library and then install it using the addzip library feature in the Arduino IDE. After successful installation, we can find the library in the include library section with the name IBM LMIC framework. Now go to the examples from the file menu and search for
IBM LMIC framework and then open the TTN-ABP example. This is the code that we are going to use for programming the LoRa and node. Before uploading code to the node, we have to make some changes to work according to our frequency and the registered device which we have done on the TTN platform. We have to add network session key, app session key, device address here. All the credentials can be found on the TTN platform. Go to TTN, copy the dev address and paste it here. Make sure the credentials should be in the same format as it is mentioned already. Don't change them. If you change, there might be some errors occur. Then copy the network session key. Click on the view key. Click on this to convert the key into the array of hexadecimal numbers. And make sure it will be in the MSB format. Copy the code and replace here. Repeat the same process for app session key. Let us change this published message. Also change the transmission interval to 15 seconds. Then change the pin configurations according to the circuit diagram. Scroll down and go to the 190th line. Here we have to provide the channel frequency in which band we are going to operate it. As we can see here, our LoRaWAN operating frequency is 865 to 867 MHz. We already know this, right? But what about channels? How can we derive the channels? Yes, good question. We cannot select some random channels and use them. There are already pre-configured channels or gateway supports. So let us use them. You can find these channels on the LoRa log page. These are the 8 channels our gateway can receive the data. So let us configure the same on the device. Copy this channel frequency and paste it here. And repeat the same process for the rest of the 8 channels. All required changes are done. Now save this file with some name, whatever you want. Wait, don't relax yet. The changes are not done yet. We have to make changes to couple of library documents. Go to the library folder, open SRC folder, and then LMIC folder, config.h and lorabase.h. We have to make changes in these two documents. First, open config.h file. Make sure EU868 is selected here. This config_sx1276_radio is set to 1. Then LMIC debug level is set to 1. And finally, LMIC failure serial uncommented. Then save the file. Open lorabase.h. Scroll down to the 73rd line and change the channel frequency according to the frequency which we have already configured on the Arduino program. Then save the file. Now come back to the Arduino IDE. Connect Arduino Uno with laptop or PC. Select the board Arduino Uno and the right port. Then click on upload. That's it, successfully uploaded. After successfully uploading, open serial monitor with baud rate 115200. If you see TX complete text on the serial monitor, congratulations, your LoRa device is transmitting LoRa data packets successfully. Open the Things Network server, go to Gateway Live Data. As you can see here, Gateway received an uplink from the device 260B501B, which is the device address of our device. Now go to the Applications Live Data. As you can see here, we have also received payload from the same device. Also, a total of 3 data packets we can see here. We can also see the spreading factor, signal to noise ratio, RSSI of the received data packet. But the payload is not readable. We have sent a message, "Hello Electronics Innovation World." But here we are receiving some random data. What could be the problem? Is there any malfunctioning happening to the data? Do you have any idea why it's happening? Yes, you are right. The data which is being transmitted over the LoRaWAN is encrypted. Here we are looking at the hexadecimal format of encrypted messages. Now we need to decrypt or convert that messages to human readable format. To decrypt the message, go to the endnotes, click on the endnote, go to the payload format, choose the formatted type JavaScript and paste this code. Wait, don't worry. You can find this code on the project page, which is mentioned in the description below. Now come back to the TTN application live data and reload the page. As you can see here, we can see the data inside of the data packet. So this is how we can decrypt the data of LoRaWAN data packets. That's it for this tutorial. We have successfully developed a LoRa and node that can be activated in APP node with RFM95 module and Arduino Uno to publish "Hello Electronics Innovation World" message. Also, we have successfully decrypted the LoRaWAN data packets and read the contents of data packets. Stay tuned to Electronics Innovation for more interesting projects on LoRaWAN communication. See you on the next video. Bye-bye.